This afternoon, the superintendent of that Southern Indiana school system released his recommendations, which include shutting down four elementary schools.
Eric King has been investigating this all day. He's now live outside of the superintendent's office in New Albany with what he's learned. Eric?
Hi, Rick. Good afternoon, Vicki. Listen, this is just a proposal at this point, but keep in mind, it's the only one that's on the table. So it's safe to say there will be changes of some sort, and effects will certainly be felt.
I just hope they don't shut it down. There's going to be a lot of parents that's going to be upset, and so are the kids.
It's one of the more common reactions across New Albany. Parents outraged over the potential shutdown of four New Albany elementary schools.
I think the education will suffer because, you know, the teachers are already saying that they're overworked and have more students than what they can handle. What are you going to do with more students and less schools?
On the list, Pineview, Children's Academy of New Albany, Galena, and Silver Street.
We have money for stupid garbage can lids. We have money for a bike lane on Spring Street that nobody gives a care about. But our children's education are going to suffer because you're going to close one of the best schools in the state. It just makes no sense.
This afternoon, New Albany Floyd County Superintendent Bruce Hibbert released his plans and recommendations to bridge a $6.6 million budget shortfall. It's a lengthy plan which includes eliminating 62 teaching positions, 5 administrative positions, 45 classified positions, and closing the 4 already mentioned schools. Other options the superintendent mentions: raising property taxes $6.6 million. That's about $225 a year on a $100,000 property. The financial fallout comes less than 3 months after Indiana Governor Mitch Daniels slashes $300 million from state school funding because of falling tax revenues.
Quite frankly, I think a lot of the problem we have is, comes from the governor's office.
Mark Hessens is the president of the New Albany Floyd County Education Association.
And you can't fund public education on a variable economy. There has to be a constant, consistent form of funding.
Our kids' education ought to come first. There's lots of other things they can chop.
And another part of this potential plan is to move all fifth graders into middle school. There is a public comment period scheduled for Monday night at the board's regularly scheduled meeting, and a final decision is expected to be made on March the 11th. And I'll tell you also, as a side note, the superintendent did not make himself available to us at all today, despite our repeated efforts to speak to him. We're live in New Albany. I'm Eric King, WLKY News.
Thank you, Eric. Now, regardless of what happens, core student programming will remain intact, and the superintendent believes student achievement and opportunity will be enhanced. Once voted on, some of the changes will begin immediately, while others will have to be phased in. Now, you can read the whole plan on our website in the top story section.